This video shows how you can use the environment equation array to render a long equation that's more than one line. I would only suggest using equation array if you can't use the AMS math package, because the AMS math package has several environments that are easier to use. To use the equation array environment, I'm going to type in backslash begin, and eqnarray is how you spell it. I'm using Text Studio, and it automatically put end eqnarray, which if you have a begin, you have to have an end. The first command I'm going to use is left eqn, and what that does is it shoves everything to the left and it ignores the other two columns. I'm going to type y equals backslash alpha plus backslash beta plus backslash gamma. And I only want it to put an equation number one time. It would put it for each of these lines. I'm going to type in backslash no number as one word. And then I put a double backslash so that it ends the row. Now, the way that equation array works is there are three columns. The first column is right aligned. The second column is center aligned. And the third column is left aligned. We want the left aligned. I'm going to put in two ampersands, so that would make the first column empty, the second column empty, and I'm putting things in the third column, which will be left aligned. And I'm going to put in double curly brackets. It's because I'm starting my line with an operator, so I just put a plus here. If I didn't have those double curly brackets, it would treat it like it was a sign on the variable, and it would put it right next to the variable, so the spacing would be off. For the next line, I'm going to put plus, then backslash delta, plus backslash omega, plus backslash tau. And again, I don't want the number to be here, so I'm going to put backslash no number as one word, then double backslash for the next line. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to have two ampersands and two curly brackets, and I'm going to start line three with a minus, and then I'm going to do backslash zeta for the zeta variable. Now, when I generate this document, it generated without a problem, so I'm going to display the document, and shows our equation.